Good evening, everyone. On behalf of Senior Pastor Clayton Coe and Sharon Coe and the worship ministry at First Assembly of God, we would like to welcome you to our 2023 Christmas production titled, The God Who Sees. Yes. We would like to first thank you all for being here, being a part of this. This is our last night. We've had some great couple of nights, Friday and Saturday night. But in a few moments, we will start our pre-show. So please begin to make your way to your seats. If you need to use the restrooms, they are located in the foyer. As you exit the doors into the foyer, to the right is the ladies' restroom, and to the left is the men's restroom. Now tonight, we do have a big crowd tonight, so we would like to kindly ask everyone if you could come towards the center. If there are seats that are open, please fill those seats towards the center first so we can fill out more towards the edge. We kindly ask everyone to please refrain from flash photography and place all electronic devices in silent mode for the listening enjoyment of our guests. Also, no food or drink is allowed in the sanctuary. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming to the stage First Assembly of God's Hula Halal.
Goes around. smile. He waves aloha with a Christmas cheer, Nele Kaliki Maka and Happy New Year.
In the meadow we can build a snowman and pretend that he is Parson Brown. He'll say, oh, you married, we'll say no, man, but you can do the job when you're in town.
Later on, we'll conspire as we dream by the fire to face and afraid the plans that we made walking in the winter wonderland. Nele Kaliki Maka and Happy New Year, we're walking in the winter wonderland.
And now, please give a warm welcome to our first Assembly of God's Children's Choir.
And children's voices singing.
At this time, we introduce to you First Assembly of God's Heritage Praise Dancers.
Said the night wind to the little lamb, do you see what I see? Way up in the sky, little lamb, do you see what I see? A star, dancing in the night, with a tail as big as a kite, with a tail as big as a kite. Said the little lamb to the shepherd boy, do you hear what I
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Michaela Freitas.
Feel it in the air, joy is everywhere, it's Christmas. Everything is shining bright, oh what a glorious night, it's Christmas. It's the greatest time of the year. It's the greatest time of the year. Yeah. Come on, let's celebrate. It's Christmas. So be of good cheer. Jesus is here. Come on, let's celebrate. Let's celebrate, it's Christmas. So be of good cheer, Jesus is here. Come on, let's celebrate, it's Christmas. So everybody sing, let the music ring. It's Christmas. Woo! It's Christmas. Yeah. Come on, let's celebrate. Come on, let's celebrate. It's Christmas. Everybody sing. Everybody sing. Come on, let's celebrate. It's Christmas. So everybody sing. And let the music ring. It's Christmas. It's Christmas. It's Christmas.
And now, please welcome to the stage, First Assembly of God's The Givers Hip Hop.
Christmas.
Wow, great job. Come on, everybody, let's give every one of our performers a great round of applause. Yes. Great job, everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, we will be starting our 2023 Christmas production shortly. We would like to again remind you to please refrain from using flash photography and place all electronic devices in silent mode for the listening enjoyment of all of our guests. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct pleasure to introduce to you the senior pastor of First Assembly of God, Senior Pastor Clayton Coe.
Merry Christmas. Would you turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, Merry Christmas. I want to take this opportunity to welcome you to our 2003 Christmas production, The God Who Sees. How many of you are glad God sees you? Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, God sees you. And he sees all of us. Praise the Lord. What a wonderful time of the year. And it's hard to believe that tonight is a final night and looks like we've got a full capacity. And I tell you, you're in for a treat because the first tonight was fabulous. God has just blessed us with tremendous talent. Did you enjoy the pre-show? Would you give them a hand of appreciation? What talent! All those young people and the singers and the dancers, man, I used to be able to dance like that in my dreams, all right? But it's amazing how God can use whatever talent we bring to him to be a blessing and to ultimately glorify his name. And tonight is about really telling again the Christmas story. And we trust that you're going to receive something and we'll really help you to kick off the Christmas season knowing the true reason for the season. I'm just curious, how many of you, this will be the first time you're seeing one of our Christmas production? Put up your hand way high. Would you look around? My goodness, where have you been? You know, I was trying to think back how long we've been doing Christmas production, even preceding my years. But it's over 45 years when we were at the old location. You might remember the Christmas tree in the Blaisdell Arena. Well, that was First Assembly of God. And we've been doing Christmas productions every year as our gift to the community. And all of the performers, all of the choir, the orchestra, the cast and crew, none of them are paid professionals. All they are doing is offering their gifts and talents to the Lord. And because they have been faithful in the little things, God is using them to tell the Christmas story. And you're gonna be blessed tonight. I know you're going to leave knowing a little bit more about the reason for the season. But what I want to do before I do that and welcome our choir and orchestra to come back, I want you to look at your chair. Under your chair, there's an envelope that looks like this. Because I believe somewhere along the program, the spirit of generosity will come upon you. And you're going to feel like, man, Christmas is about giving. And praise God, the greatest gift that we could ever receive is Jesus Christ, right? And we are blessed because of the greatest gift of forgiveness, the Savior that was born as to forgive us of our sins. And so we're going to ask that throughout the program, if God speaks to you and you want to give a generous offering, here's the envelope. I can't sing, I can't play, but I can help raise the money to pay for this Christmas production, all right? So I just want to leave that with you. On the way out, you'll be able to leave an offering to help us to continue to give the Christmas gift as a gift to the community. And so without any further ado, I want you to help me by putting your hands together and welcoming the Christmas production, The God Who Sees. Put your hands together.
Well, I'm so excited. Christmas is almost here. I love it. Just look around. It's everywhere. Can you feel it?
Yes, Michaela, I can. And I'm with you. Christmas is my most favorite time of the year. I love everything about Christmas, from the chill in the air to the fresh smells of evergreen, gingerbread cookies baking, chestnuts roasting. You know what else I love? Driving through the city to look at all the beautiful decorations and colorful lights.
I like going caroling. That's really fun.
Oh, the music. There's just something about Christmas music that makes me feel warm and fuzzy inside. What about you, Kai?
Me? I love the present. Just give me lots of them.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at the 5 and 10 glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes aglow.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door.
A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolls that will talk and will go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start. And the thing that will make them ring is the carol that you sing. Right within your heart.
Right within your heart.
Michaela, more than all the smells, the sights, the sounds of Christmas, what I love the most is the story behind Christmas.
The story?
Haven't you heard the story of Christmas?
No, I don't think I have.
You're kidding, right? You know baby Jesus, the star, the wise men? Aw, come on.
Oh, Michaela is the very best part of Christmas. He's truly the reason for the season.
Who is?
Jesus! God gave the most precious gift ever to all the world, his only son.
That's why we get presents. Thank Jesus.
Well, okay. Tell me.
Okay. Well, listen carefully and you'll hear the story unfold.
Flesh and dwelt among us. This is the story of Christmas. Since the fall of man in the Garden of Eden, sin has separated all of us from the holiness of God. For centuries, the payment for the penalty of sin was through a blood sacrifice. Countless innocent lambs were slain in an attempt to obtain righteousness before God. However, our Heavenly Father had a master plan. He chose to send his one and only Son, Jesus, to give his life as the final payment for all sin. And so, after 400 years of silence between God and his people, he sent a messenger to a chosen one, a young virgin girl named Mary.
Greetings, O favored one, the Lord God is with you. And will be great. high, and he will reign, and he will reign, for his kingdom will never end.
Mary embraced the angel's words, but her betrothed husband, Joseph, was troubled by the news. Made plans to quietly end his engagement to Mary, but an angel appeared to him in a dream, saying, "Fear not, for that which is conceived in Mary is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." And it came to pass that the decree went out that the whole Roman Empire should be registered. Joseph took Mary and began the wearisome journey to the town of his ancestors, Bethlehem. They found a town overwhelmed with people, and they could find no place to stay. Mary knew the time to deliver the baby was near, so Joseph pleaded with an innkeeper, who offered them shelter in a stable. There, in the presence of lowly cattle and sheep, Mary gave birth to Jesus, the King of Heaven, who could have come in regal robes on a mighty horse, surrounded by angelic armies. Chose to come softly, sweetly, as a newborn baby lying in a manger. Quiet stillness blanketed the town. The streets were empty. The marketplace sat dormant, and on the outskirts of town, shepherds kept a sleepy but watchful eye on their flocks. A gentle breeze drifted through the fields underneath a velvet sky as time almost seemed to stand still. Suddenly, the calm was broken by immense light as an angel of the Lord burst forth from heaven with a proclamation. "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring good news of great joy, which shall be for all the world." Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born, a Savior who is Christ the Lord. Now you must go and find him. Look for a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. All at once, the skies were consumed by a massive choir of angels as their voices rang out in triumphant praise.
Glory to God in the highest.
The shepherds did as the angel told them, and they found the Christ child lying in the manger. They shared the news with all that would hear, and they came to worship. People who walked in darkness have seen a great light. To those who dwelt in the land of deep darkness, new light has dawned. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, and of his kingdom there shall be no end.
Thank you.
morning star rose over the place where Jesus was born. It led three wise men from the east to come and worship.
Thank you.
frankincense for the Lord above all lords. Myrrh for the sacrifice to end all sacrifices. Gold for the king above all kings.
I know why you love this part of Christmas the most. To understand why Jesus was born, that God gave us his only son to pay for all of our wrong choices and mistakes. I mean, that's really huge.
I don't get it. How can a tiny little baby save all the naughty people in the world? I need to know, because I'm pretty naughty.
Well, I was wondering the same thing.
Well, Jesus grew up and was full of wisdom. He taught us how we should live. He was willing to give up his life so we could be forgiven for all of our naughtiness. And he was very obedient.
I try.
Just trust and believe in him, Kai. He'll help you through everything.
Wow, he loves us that much?
He really does. I just tear up thinking about it.
Oh no, not again. Girls.
Oh, stop it, Kai. When you think about it, the humble birth of Jesus demonstrated God's love even for the least of us.
What do you mean?
The world is so messed up sometimes. Things can happen unexpectedly. All of us go through life having to face tough times and hard things like addiction, loss of a loved one, poverty, financial crisis, and sometimes tragic illness. The struggle is real. Yet there's always hope because we have a God who sees us and meets us at our every need. We needed a Savior. He gave us his son, Jesus.
Unlike most people, I know exactly what I was doing on 19 June 2019. At age 57, I was on my knees surrendering to God, confessing my sins and repenting for over 40 years of prodigal living. A child of divorce, my parents' separation left a spiritual void in me, one I filled with selfish and worldly pursuits becoming an alcohol and porn addict, and pursuing sexual immorality. Introverted and lacking self-worth, I isolated myself from family and friends. At 27, I joined the Army and found that if I worked hard, my personal life was of no concern. Professionally, I excelled, earning awards and promotions. But the emptiness remained, and my willful disobedience to God demanded more and more of my time, my money, my morality. On three occasions, suicide was more than a fleeting thought, but always a still voice spoke life over death. In hindsight, even in my most desperate moments, I know God was attempting to reach through the dark veil surrounding me, carrying me when I was too weak to go on. After a DUI, I started attending church, but remained under Satan's deception, being unworthy of God's infinite love and forgiveness, unable to break free for another 11 years. I now clearly see God's pathway that led to my breaking point, no longer to escape accountability for my sinful life. I reached my prodigal epiphany in the pig pen. On that blessed morning, I transformed from life of humiliation to humbly receiving Christ as my Savior, liberating me from the enemy's strongholds to receive God's glorious redemption and salvation. I embraced God's plan, becoming a member of First Assembly. Got into service in church, joined 12-step recovery programs, and sought therapy and counseling. Through this, I learned to love and forgive myself, transformed to be a blessing to others, and selflessly serve God's kingdom. I've answered calls for short-term missions twice and will continue to follow his narrow path and perfect timing. Most recently, this included being there for my mother in late stages of dementia, something I would not have been able or willing to do just 5 years ago. I'm still a sinner and fall short of God's glory. But no, God's perfect love will never fail to deliver me from what the enemy meant for evil. In this celebration, in the season when we celebrate the gift of our Savior, let the message be received of God's deliverance from our sinfulness. Jesus is the answer to break chains and free the captives, shining his eternal life over all his children and nations. All praise and glory in his exalted name.
So I was married for 20 years, and in 2019, my husband and I got a divorce, and it happened so fast, we didn't even know, like, really what happened. I see it now that I had a lot of pride, and I ran. I just got out of it without seeking God at all, without fighting for my marriage, and spinning out for a little while. There was no chance. I didn't even think about reconciliation at all. I just ran. I moved back home where I'm originally from. Originally actually from Oahu, but I moved to the Big Island. When I got there, I started working at this job. It was a med spa in Hilo. And I worked there for not even like a month. And I remember the Lord saying to me on the way home one day, serve me or serve yourself. I quit that job right away. And I started serving with Teen Challenge of the Hawaiian Islands, Home of Hope on the Big Island out in Nanavale. So I was there for 10 months before coming to Christian Academy and FAOG. And I also started serving, you know, at our church. And I believe that's where I started to get stronger with my faith and connected with God, more of God and less of me. And so on Mother's Day, I was sitting through first service and I was just praying and praying. And during the second service, my daughter Raj called me and I hadn't talked to her in 3 years. So I took the phone outside and I answered the call and I couldn't believe it was her. She tells me, Mom, I don't want another year to go by without you in my life.
And I believe that was the door that opened. So shortly after that in June, when school ended, I went right over to visit her, and she was in Arizona. And automatically, right away, reconciliation just took place. You know, we didn't even talk about the past. God just had so much favor on us. And little did I know that I would also be reconciled with my husband. Our hearts were just softened. You know, God dealt with him the way God needed to deal with him, and God dealt with me. We had to go through the journey, you know, and I'm just so grateful that I got to go through that and come out even stronger.
Good evening. Thank you for the opportunity to share a part of my life story with you. I've been a practicing physician for over 40 years. During that time, circumstances have made it necessary on occasion for me to inform a family of the passing of their loved one. Feelings of sadness and grief that they go through is almost palpable. Personally, I've gone through the grieving of my grandparents, father, younger brother, and several close relatives and friends. I thought I could see or had seen and could handle it all. But I was ill prepared for the gut punch of loneliness and emptiness with the passing of Mimi, my wonderful wife of 26 years. She was taken by ovarian cancer. During that time, a few months before the ending of her life, she was able to be at home under hospice care. Our two sons and myself were primary caregivers. I had a profound experience. I truly understood what it means to love someone unconditionally. Attending to her daily functional needs caused me to experience a depth of love that I hadn't realized was in my heart. Each night, she would ask me to read a Bible devotion and pray with her. What a joy it was for us to share our love in this way. How I miss her these 3 years she's been gone. November 29th was her birthday. So the past 3 years since her going home to Jesus, it seems like a double whammy of loneliness and emptiness, the loss of her, and the flood of memories associated with her during that Thanksgiving and Christmas season. Each year, the sadness, loneliness, and emptiness return, but thank God, not as painful as that initial grief. Now I've learned to take that joy and love I experienced serving Mimi and use it to serve our Lord. 1 Thessalonians 5:16 through 18 says, "Rejoice always. in everything, give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. That's how I get through the holiday season. A joyful heart filled by the love of Jesus Christ. Thank you.
So, you see, Michaela and Kai, God's plan to bring us back to Him one day was a very costly one. Only one who was without sin could be a worthy sacrifice. And that one and only came as a truly innocent baby on that very first Christmas day. Yet, as I read my Bible, I've come to realize we were always on God's heart, even way before Jesus was born. He saw and watched over all those who trusted and believed in Him. They were given hope to carry on while waiting for the promise of Jesus.
She was abandoned by the family she belonged to, and there in the wilderness with her son, alone with very little provision, she was wandering. She was questioning. Does anyone care? She's crying in the desert. She's lost in her despair. She thinks nobody loves her. Hagar thinks nobody's there. But God says, I will be. Another woman named Ruth. She was from the land of Moab. She was met with grief and heartache. She was a widow, and she lived with her mother-in-law, who was also a widow. And now, it was time to move on. But Ruth had never been to Bethlehem. She had never tasted of the house of bread. But now she had heard an inner invitation to come and taste and see. And so she vowed herself to her mother-in-law. And she said, where you go, I will go. Where you lie, I will lie. Where you die, I will die. And she begins a journey to the promised land. She's traveling through the desert. She's leaving her despair. She's hoping for a future, praying God will lead her there. And he says, I will put a ring around your finger, and I will bless the child within your womb, and the Savior will be born through you to free the world from sin, and he'll make all things new for you and love you back to life again. Then from Ruth, who gave birth to a son, Obed, who gave birth to a son, Jesse, who gave birth to a son named David. Now the same once shepherd boy, mighty warrior, anointed king, is alone, terrified in the darkness. He's hiding in the desert. He's battling despair. David thinks his life is over. It's over. And God, he doesn't care. But God says, I will be the rock of your salvation. I'll hold you up by the strength of my right hand, and the power of my spirit will free you from all fear. In the hour of your deepest need, you'll find of David, finally, Jesus, the Messiah, the anointed one, Yeshua the Christ, born in the same house of bread to be the bread of life in the town of Bethlehem. And he would grow, and he would be called the Son of God. He would be called Emmanuel, God with us. And he would heal, and he would reveal. And then he had an encounter with a woman named Mary of Magdalene. She was plagued by demons, tormented by evil spirits. And Jesus, he set her free. So Mary followed Jesus. She listened at his feet. She served him and she loved him. Oh, how she loved him. But then she watched as they nailed him to the cross. And as they placed his body in the tomb, in that moment, her hope died. It died. She's crying in the garden. She's broken in despair. She's searching for her Savior, but his body isn't there. Then he says,
Mary.
Powerful. We've come to the most important part of our program, and I'm going to ask parents, would you please try to keep your child as quiet as possible, because this is a very sacred moment. The message tonight is God sees you. I don't know what you're going through, where you're coming from, but God word to you tonight is that he sees you. He sees you in your sufferings. He sees you in your loneliness. He sees you in your rejections, your addictions, your loss, your griefs. He saw Hagar. The story that was sung is a true story, actually. God saw a woman who was actually a slave. He saw her in the wilderness. The story goes that God made a promise to Abraham and Sarah that they would have a promised son. But Sarah was barren and she couldn't bear. And so instead of trusting God, she told her servant, I want you to sleep with Abraham and bear me a son so that I could have a child. Now, that wasn't God's will, but she did that anyway. Then when Hagar got pregnant, she got jealous and she kicked him out and she ends up in the wilderness. That's messed up, right? The story is that the Bible is filled with a lot of messes, but how many of you know God can turn our mess into a message? Only God can turn our mess into a message. We have many messes in our lives, and God wants us to know whatever mess you find yourself in, he sees you. He sent an angel to Hagar to let her know that God sees her and that God would bless her with a son that will become great. And he said, I want you to call his name Ishmael. Do you know what Ishmael means? Ishmael means God hears. So God not only sees, but God was telling Hagar, I not only see you, I hear the cries of your heart. God hears you. He sees your situation, but he wants you to know that he hears the pain in your heart. He hears your doubts, your questions. He hears the anger, the frustration, wondering, is there anyone who cares? Does anyone really care about what I'm going through? I want you to know God cares. God cares. And that is the reason why he sent Jesus Christ into this world. Because the Bible says God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hagar was so blessed by that experience. She said something so profound. She said she gave this name to the Lord who spoke to her. You are the God who sees me. For she said, I have now seen the one who sees me. That is incredible. She was so blessed by that experience. And she said, you're the God who sees me. For I have now seen the one who sees me. You see, it's not so much that God sees you, because most of us kind of can accept the fact that God sees me and he hears me. But here's the thing. She says, now I see the one who sees me. Wow. Now, I don't think she meant that she saw him physically, because no one can see God. What she was saying was she had an encounter with God. She saw God. She experienced God. She had a moment of encounter with the Lord where all of a sudden that loneliness was filled with the presence of God. And God wants you to know tonight, you are not alone. He's there with you. You can see him. In fact, Jesus said it himself, he who sees the Son sees the one who sent him. He is Emmanuel. He is God with us. And today, at this moment, in this season, when everyone's celebrating, but inside your heart you're crying, is there anyone who cares? Is anyone knows? No one can understand what I'm going through. I want you to know Jesus understands your pain because he bore your pain. He bore the sufferings. He bore the sins of the world. He's the only one that can truly understand what you're going through. And he invites you today. He invites you to open up your heart. Ask him to come into your heart. Christmas is about receiving the greatest gift that anyone could ever receive. That is the gift of salvation, the gift of forgiveness through the Lord Jesus Christ, so that you can now see the God who sees you through Jesus Christ. You can have a personal relationship with God Almighty through Jesus Christ. When someone offers you a gift, all you have to do is by faith accept the gift. God says, I want to give you eternal life. I want to give you forgiveness. But it's up to you to accept it by faith and say, I receive it. Forgiveness is free. Can I hear an amen? But the only reason it's free is because Jesus paid the price for forgiveness. You don't have to work for it. You don't have to earn it. All you need to do is say, I receive. And in a few moments, I'm going to give you that opportunity to by faith receive Jesus into your heart. I'm going to ask all of us to bow our heads together to give your neighbor the privacy. And if you're here this evening, I know God brought you here. God brought you here, not just for a performance. God brought you here so that you can see the one who sees you. You can see the one who hears you. You can experience and have a personal relationship like Craig had, like Dr. Paul had, like Deborah had on the screen. You can have. And through all of their journey, God saw them. And at the right time, they had an encounter, a personal encounter with Jesus Christ. And tonight is your moment. Tonight is your night to have an appointment, an encounter by opening up your heart and receiving Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. So in a few moments, I'm going to give you that opportunity. With every head bowed and every eye closed, if you are here and you know and you're saying, I need that. That's what I've been looking for. I've made it to the top, or I have a lot of stuff in life, but the one thing, there's still an emptiness. The only one that can fill that emptiness is the Lord Jesus Christ. And so tonight, God is offering you the free gift of salvation through His Son, Jesus Christ. The question is, will you accept that gift or say, no, I forget it. Forget it. I just humble yourself and say, that's what I need. So tonight, I'm going to just count to three. And without any hesitation, when I count to three, if you know, you would say, Pastor, would you pray for me? I need Jesus. I want to make tonight, this Christmas season, the night that I surrender my life to Jesus and invite Him to come in. Or maybe you once did when you were young, like Craig was a prodigal son, but you're saying, tonight, I want to come back to Jesus. When I count to three, don't hesitate. Just put your hand up, and I want to pray for you. You might say, Pastor, why should I put my hand up? Because when your heart says yes, your hand goes up. You're acknowledging, yes, Lord. One. Two. Don't hesitate. In every place, in all of the sanctuary, you lift your hand up. Three. Put up your hand. Put it up. Put it up. Put it up. Lift up your hand. Lift up your hand. If you know you need Jesus, put it way high. And just keep your hand lifted, because someone will come to you and they're going to put a card in your hand. And this card, we're going to give to you, because on the way out, we want to give you a gift of your decision tonight on the way out to redeem this card. You need to just go on and turn it in right as you go to the exit. But we want to pray for you. If you know you need Jesus, you put up your hand and say, Pastor, pray for me. I need Jesus. If you're sitting next to someone and they lifted your hand, would you wave down the ushers that are in the aisle and make sure they get a card? And we want to make sure that everyone that lifted their hand to accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior would receive a gift that we have for you on the way out. Doesn't matter whether you're young or old, every one of us, we can accept that gift of salvation. We can know the one who sees us. Amen. Praise God. And so I know we're all trying to get everyone a card. Those of you that lifted your hand to receive Jesus Christ and acknowledging that you need the Lord, I want you to do this one thing with me. I want to pray for all of us. And I want you to lead you in a simple prayer of asking Jesus into your heart to make him the Lord and Savior of your life. All right? So would you put one hand on your heart and lift the other hand up with all of us? Just one hand on your heart and lift the other one up, because we're going to pray from our heart to our Father in heaven. But I want us all to pray this prayer together in unity. All right? Let's pray it out loud. All right? Are you ready? Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for loving me. I thank you for seeing me. I thank you for hearing me. I thank you for sending Jesus Christ into this world to die for my sins. I confess I am a sinner and I need a Savior. But I thank you tonight, through the Christmas story, I know God loves me, and he sent Jesus Christ, his only son, into this world to die for my sins. So I confess I am a sinner and I need a Savior. And I ask you, Jesus, come into my heart, be my Lord and my Savior. I give you my heart. I give you my life. I want to live for you from this day forward, just as you died for me. And I thank you, Lord, that according to my prayer and by faith, God is my Father, Jesus is my big brother, the Holy Spirit is my helper, the church is my new family, the devil is my enemy, and I am a child of God. And I am a child of God. Amen and amen. Give the Lord a great big clap offering. Amen. So please be sure to stop off on the way out and redeem your card for a gift. Praise God. Would you help me to welcome back the choir, the orchestra, and the casting crew for the finale?
That falls, and he is me where.
Today, in a world of terror, he offers us hope. In all our human inadequacies, he offers strength. In times of war, he offers us unconditional peace. And right here and now, he offers you and me love.
It doesn't say joy to Mary and Joseph, but joy to the world. They were parents of a newborn son, but all of humankind from that day to this are the recipients of a Savior.
At this very moment, we are not alone, for he is Emmanuel, God with us. He is Savior. He is Lord. Let every heart prepare him room. Let heaven and nature sing. Seek joy, joy to the world, for the Lord is come.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let us receive our King. Let every heart sing, and heaven and nature sing, heaven and heaven and nature.
someone shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, give the Lord Jesus a hand. Amen. Would you give a hand to our choir? Our cast and crew, give them a hand. What about our orchestra? Weren't they awesome? Give a hand. Pastor Fred, praise God. Would you give Pastor Fred a hand? Wow. I'm going to ask you, if you would, just to indulge Pastor Fred just for a few moments, because this could not be possible except for the key people that were overseeing different departments. As you can see, it takes a lot of people to make this production a great success. And I'm going to invite Pastor Fred to come on up and just to call just the key leaders. And we want you to see who's actually behind the scenes directing all of these different groups of dancers, singers, actors, choir, orchestra. Would you once again put your hands together for Pastor Fred? Amen.
Wow. Come on, let's shout hallelujah to the risen King, the baby Jesus. Well, the first thing I want to do is thank each and every one of these fine men and women of God that's come together, our orchestra, our choir, the dance ministries, our townspeople, drama.
Yes.
Give them another hand.
Woo.
I have truly enjoyed this journey that we've gone on. And just quickly, I want to share just a little bit about how this came about. As we prepared for this year, we were thinking, we came together, myself and Lehua and Janice, and Lehua introduced that song, The God Who Sees to Me, and that song resonated in my spirit, and I said, we have to do this, and as the Lord began to share more of it, he said, we're going to be dealing with three types of people this year. We also thought about the Maui fires and people that have gone through that. And we knew that three people we would be ministering to. First, those that would be, come on, let's face it, they're cursing God because of what happened, right? They're saying, how would a God that loves someone would allow these kind of things to happen? We wanted to minister to those tonight as well. The second group is those who know God but are in an indecisive place, and so they're questioning God. And then there's the other group that knows God, but just need that little encouragement to know that God hears and sees. Amen? And we believe that those are the people that we're ministered to tonight. And I pray that you are all in that. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Well, as Pastor said, there are many people that contributed to this. And I tell you, I am so blessed to have a great committee that comes together and also team people that come together. I just want to mention a few. First of all, let's give a hand for Pastor Co and Sister Co. for their vision and for the granting us the opportunity to do this. This is not an automatic given, but each year, Pastor asks, are we going to do a Christmas production? And I say, yes, let's do it. The elders and pastoral staff, thank you all, the entire staff that comes together to put this, give them a hand, yes. Also, I cannot do this without my wife, Sandra Harris. She's my helpmeet. I don't know, she may be doing grandmother duties tonight. She's taking care of our grandchild. Oh, there she is. Come out here.
Yes.
And this is our little Jaira Joy. Yes. Aw. Praise God. But let's on to. Okay, Lehua Crawford, where are you? Lehua and Janice Bowick. These two were instrumental in bringing together what you saw here tonight in vision. Okay, Lehua, Janice Bowick, my co-producer. Come.
Janice, come.
Lehua, I don't know. Lehua was up there, so I don't know. She may make it down sometime. Okay, Brenda Abero. Here comes Lehua. Come, Lehua. Lehua has also been instrumental in the decorations that you see here. Such a great decorator and just a co-laborer with me as well as with Janice Bowick. Amen. Brenda Barrow, our production assistant. I know she may be still up there.
Coming up this step.
Okay. Lauren Afredalusis, one of our production assistants as well. Brenda? Yes. Our concert master, Miss Megumi Ogihara. This lady wears so many hats. But I tell you, wow, thank you, Megumi. Caroline Osborne, our choir section leader. Jonah Lin Chua, yes, our section leader. Nicole Santos, our tenor section leader. Nicole Santos, forget her name, huh? we have John Luna, our bass section leader. Miss Sherry Lavatai, our orchestra. She wears two hats, our orchestra director, or assistant, and also the Hulua Halau. She oversees that as well. Yes, we have also Bethany Pasatiempo, the Givers Hip Hop. Where is she? There, she's over there, okay. We also have Kiani Keohoho, the Heritage Praise Dancer Coordinator. We have Kimberly Long, our stage manager. Miss Kimberly Long and her assistant, Lei Igegami. Yes. We also have Shannon Kekua, who assists Lehua with the stage decorations. Shannon, are you around? If not, we give you applause, Shannon. Yes. Max Maeda, who's not here with us, he helped us with the stage construction. We have Pastor Raymond, who oversees our IT and facilities, helped us greatly. Yes. And his assistants, Roger Corpus, Rodney Baptiste, and Van Shimabukura. Did you love the video and the our big video wall here, LED wall? Well, none other than Brooks Invante and his group. They hide out up here. You probably don't see them, but behind the scenes, they're doing great video engineering for us. We also have Lester Akawili, our sound assistant. And our friend from Rhema Services, Kevin Jark, back on the soundboard, making us sound great. And also Rhema Services with Pat Koo. We also have Linda and Paul Carter and their team, Willette Santiago, Noella Narimatsu, and our newest one, Annette Melendrez. Yes, where are you? Come on out. You see all these wonderful costumes, the King's costumes? They were instrumental in bringing those. I don't know if they were coming there. Okay, Miss Kimberly Abe, makeup. Pastor Sam Cockett, our hospitality, they fed us very well for this production. Doug Harrod and his team, assistants. We also have Pastor Horace, who is over security and parking. We thank you for all of that. Here's our costumes team here. Yes, they're the people behind the scenes making all of our costumes look as authentic as we can, right? All right. Just a few others. We want to thank Pastor Su Ping for prayer. Oh, looks like it went away. Where'd it go?
You need Apple iPad.
It went away on me. Oh, there it is. Okay, let's continue. Just a few more here. Pastor Francine Kebab for the altar workers coordination is wonderful. And we'll get a number of people that have said yes to Jesus. We'll get that number. Pastor Trenton Oshiro, our ushers and greeters coordinator. Brother Larry Hamlet, usher's assistant. Pastor Andrew, marketing director. You see the nice flyers that you picked up. We also have Pastor Shaiju Sathanesan, who's our communications manager, overseeing that, and his crew, Gavin Terrakina from graphics, and Norma English, housekeeping, keeping everything clean and nice for us, Pastor Scott Sonoda and the house managers, and Pastor Horace and Pastor Tole Chi Manuia, who helped with the church decorations. Hallelujah. No, that was a big list, but I thank God for each and every one here that has helped to make this a powerful witness to the community. The only thing we ask now is that you share what you've seen here tonight with others. And we pray that we do this again next year, Pastor Cole.
Amen.
Amen. And again, I just want to thank the Lord for allowing us the grand opportunity to witness to the community. And we just give all honor and glory to God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Come on, give the Lord a great big clap offering for all of these. Now, on the way out, don't forget, those of you that need to turn in a card, please do so. And how many of you feel the spirit of generosity coming upon you? So make sure that you put something in here. And on the way out, we have Jesus helpers with blinking lights around their neck collecting the offering. So please help us with that. I know truly this is a great time to give to the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Would you bow your heads? Father, we thank you once again for a great weekend, Father. We thank you for the message, the story of Christmas. Once again, Lord, I pray that, Lord, as we go our separate ways, you will be with us, protect us, use us for your glory and honor, and bring us back together at your appointed time. We love you. We give you praise in Jesus' name. And everyone together say, amen. Amen. Merry Christmas.
Yeah. One name we did forget, and that's Miss Trudy Smallwood with the children's. Didn't you love those children? Such a great job. Amen. Hallelujah.